On this episode of Lawyer Reacts, we're going to talk about a video that recently came across my For You page and why the acts of the officer were unconstitutional and the detention of this individual was unreasonable.
Right back over as soon as you can. Don't drive in the shoulder for an extended amount of time, okay?
All right.
Couple more questions.
Important note here. You see that the officer gave him the traffic citation. The traffic stop is done at that point. That's important.
Couple more questions for you. Is there anything in the vehicle that would be of concern to me? Like guns, bombs, hand grenades, terrorists, dead bodies?
No.
Any open containers of alcohol, beer, wine, or liquor?
No.
Any illegal drugs?
No.
Marijuana?
No.
Cocaine?
No.
Heroin?
No.
Methamphetamine?
No.
Fentanyl?
No.
Large amounts of U.S. money?
No.
Would you have a problem if I searched this vehicle?
Yes.
So you're telling me no, I can't?
Why would you have reason to search this vehicle?
I'm just asking.
I would not like for you to search this vehicle. I'd like to get back on the road.
Okay. So basically I have a canine so I can do an open air sniff of the vehicle, okay? If he does alert to it, then that obviously gives me probable cause to search this vehicle, okay?
Okay.
You cool with that?
No. I'm not cool with that. I'd like to just get back on the road.
Right. If there's something in here you're worried about, like
there's nothing in here that I'm worried about.
Nothing at all?
No. I'm wondering why you would want to search this car.
It's what I do every single day. I search cars.
Every car that you pull over?
No, not every car.
Why would you want to search this car then?
I'm just asking.
And I'm just asking you.
And you can tell me no, and that you're right.
I've said
no. And I can tell you I have a canine, so I can be able to run it on the vehicle, okay?
And you asked me if I'd like for you to do that, and I also said no.
Well, you don't have to be okay with that part.
So you just get to
do that. It was a courtesy.
So you just get to do that?
Give me a second. I'll be right back with you, okay? I'm going to make a phone call, and I'll be right back, okay?
What do you need to make a phone call for?
What?
What do you need to make a phone call for? Am I being detained?
Give me a second, I'll be right back.
Am I being detained?
At this point, you are, okay?
I am being detained.
At this point, you are.
What for?
Because I said you are, okay?
No.
So, no,
but what am I being detained for?
Okay? For me to deploy my canine, okay?
Why do you need to?
The United States Supreme Court held in Rodriguez versus United States that an officer may not extend a traffic stop past the ordinary amount of time needed in order to conduct a dog sniff unrelated to the original reason for the stop. In this case, we see that at the first clip, the officer gives the individual his ticket. The traffic stop is done at that point. It is over. However, he then goes on to ask him a series of questions about what may be in the vehicle. He's trying to get probable cause in order to search the vehicle. The officer later goes on to say that he has a canine and he's going to conduct an open air sniff in order to get probable cause to search the vehicle. The problem with that is the traffic stop is over and he has no reason to detain the individual at that time. He also stated that he is detaining him and would not give him a reason. Basically, because he did not have a reason to detain him. In this case, what the driver did was absolutely correct. He recorded the interaction, he complied with the officer and did what the officer told him to do, but made sure to maintain his record of the ordeal. That is the way you need to conduct yourself in a traffic stop, especially if you feel like something is going wrong. The individual who filmed this did a fantastic job. Whether there's a potential lawsuit in this, I don't know, just speculation. I did see comments from this creator saying that they searched the vehicle, that the dog alerted, that they didn't find anything, and he was allowed to go on his way. When we're talking about damages, you know, was there economic damages? Did he get fired? Did he lose out money from being stopped? You know, did it cause him some sort of post-traumatic stress? I don't know. Again, speculatory at this point. However, it's important to note that when an officer hands you the citation, the traffic stop is over, and technically you should be free to leave at that point. The United States Supreme Court has held that police detention of a person is a seizure by the definition of the Fourth Amendment's prohibition against unreasonable searches and seizures. Here, the seizure was unreasonable. He had no probable cause to seize him. He had no reasonable suspicion. And the traffic stop had been concluded. Now, an attorney on the other side could say that he did have reasonable suspicion that something was going on. However, he should have articulated that prior to terminating the traffic stop. because the traffic stop had been terminated, at that point, he did not have any probable cause to search the vehicle, and thus, he had no reason to detain him. To play devil's advocate, if I was advising the officer, I would have told him to conduct the open air sniff with the canine while he was writing the ticket. They can extend that time that a reasonable traffic stop takes by going slow. So had he had the animal sniff the vehicle while he was still writing the ticket, it wouldn't have been unreasonable. Either way, it seems that this was an unreasonable detention of this person. Whether there's any damages, though, it's tough to say. However, it's important to note that you should always film your interactions because the police are always filming their interactions with you. It keeps everybody safe. We'll see if anything comes out of this, but luckily this is a no harm, no foul situation. Always be cordial, always be polite on both sides, and it makes the interactions go a lot easier.